Hello, I'm and good day all. This is Tihilon 29 back again. This time I'm here to speak on my top four Naoki Urasawa manga that I have personally read through. Now, the titles that I'll be covering will be Master Keaton, Pluto, Monster, and last but not least, 20th Century Boys. So, starting off with first things first, what is the last one, or in other words, what is my number four in my top four Naoki Urasawa manga? Surprisingly, it is 20th Century Boys. Now, one thing I really like about 20th Century Boys is actually the art style in relation to the characters. Now, I think that is one thing which this series actually excels at. But when it comes down to one of the key topics within the story, and that is the focusing of the cult of friend. In that, I feel that it actually falls away in regards to sort of like showing how intimidating this particular cult is. And with that, it does actually fail in the actual cult itself. And this is where I feel where Naoki Urasawa could have actually taken some ideas from some of his other works that sort of like, or some of his works, or one of his most favorite works, quite likely that may have been out at the time, and that is actual Monster, to which Monster itself actually executes the, I guess, the cult-like perspective way better than the 20th Century Boys itself. So that is finishing off number four. Now, moving into number three, it is Master Keaton. Now, if it's one thing I like with Master Keaton, when you're reading through each of the volumes, especially of the Perfect Editions, it feels like you're starting a new story, a new location. It reminds me a little bit like Indiana Jones stories, but slightly different. Yes, you are following this character who also has his own daughter on top of that. But one thing which I feel that Master Keaton, but it also shows in some of the other things that Naoki Urasawa has done in what I have presently read through, is that whilst I was reading Master Keaton, there were like a number of faces that showed up within the story, and these could just be random kids. But a lot of these random kids also had a lot of the same faces. But apart from that, the story was really linear to follow. It was a really good linear story. And with this story, each volume progressed into something new to which the character was experiencing. Yes, you got to experience within the story, like things such as discrimination, but not just discrimination, but also things to which the character would be discovering about, like, other people. And you've got his own sort of, like, his own personal form of detective work, even though he's not a detective. We learned that he's a member of the SAS. I feel that there was sort of like more, a lot of gaps that were filled that were really set up with the character of Master Keaton, along with his family, friends, and a myriad of other people that you actually meet in the story. Jumping to number three, jumping to number two, not number three, it is Monster. Now, if it's one thing that Monster As you follow the character of Johann Liebert and also Master Tenma, as he's trying to sort of like discover a mystery, is did he make a mistake in saving this person's life when they were younger, only for this person to become a monster? But adding on top of that is that we learn to see that there's a bit of a mystery, as we learn that Johann Liebert actually had a sister, and there's actual clues there that you follow in relation to the sister. And with this, we have the sister meeting up with like a young character known as Dieter along the way, or Dieter or Dietrich. And as Dr. Tenma himself is doing investigations into Johann Liebert, we learn a bit of like how the character grew up, to even there was like a form of event of things to which, yes, there was actually a bit of a cult like gathering or set up with the character. And with that, I really feel that it executed the full-on intimidation in regards to this character. But we also learned a bit of a subversion of expectations in relation to the character itself. So we learned that the importance of his sister in this story, as she also tries to go out of her way to stop Dr. Tenma from attempting to stop Johann Liebert. On top of that, we also have a character or an investigator who believes that Master Tenma is lying about Johann. So it is really well set up with that particular story. And last but not least, for number one, it has to be Pluto. Now, with Pluto, I ended up watching not only the anime twice through, but I have also read through the manga twice through. If it's one thing about Pluto that I really enjoyed, it almost feels that Naoki Urasawa could literally set up, like within this world that he created within Pluto, that you could literally restart an animated series set around the character of Astro Boy, who is also called Atom within the story. And whilst this is like set on a murder case, which we follow the character of Gashit, with Gashit we end up meeting like other characters that are from this, I guess this almost somewhat dystopian robot world with robots along with humans. I enjoyed a characterization of many of the characters, including the character of Atom himself, because he does actually return again at the end of the story, and how they also adapted the story to screen. So until then, let's keep it colorful and have yourself an awesome day. And if you were someone picking your top four out of these top four that I have read through, what would yours be? Until then, let's keep it colorful and have yourself an awesome day.